good governance. It's where we get things done. It's where we make a difference. Look, I got to be honest with you. Maps and the way we've done it have such a big influence in my life. I'm trained as a geographer and spent over 2 decades teaching in the public schools, teaching geography. In 1992, I got an opportunity. It was the National Geographic Summer Geography Institute. And it was at that conference that you got all kinds of freebies, pens, whatever it is. But there was something that I'm like, well, what is this? And it was some floppy disk with a user's manual this thick of something called GIS from a company called Esri. And I went back home and I learned how to use that. And I said to my colleagues, this is going to change the world. The tools of GIS and the science behind this and the ability to communicate make a huge difference. As governor, the ability to use what I knew about mapping to convey complex issues to affect change amongst people is really important. I want to thank all the Esri folks, all the developers, everybody who does this. These executive portfolios that they put together with us allow us an opportunity to do some amazing things. And what we're able to do is, if you're looking, you're seeing our portfolio, is to be able to go to a massive amount of data that's able to come up, and able for us to translate our vision of the type of world we want to live in with the policies that we are able to pass and then to implement them. This map that you're looking at here, this map is Corps of Engineers river gauges that give real-time river depth and almost to the minute predictions of crest of where they're coming. If you saw that picture on TV of that dam that was failing, wouldn't you know that was 6 miles up the Blue Earth River from my house, actually, is where it was at. We had a catastrophic rainstorm, very unusual for Minnesota this late. We didn't have any snow last year, so there was no snow melt. That's usually when our flooding comes. So the flooding was a little different. The patterns were a little different of where we were at, but we're able to use this map to be able to deploy resources accordingly, and now we have more data on flood mitigation and what does a summer flood look like versus the thaw out floods that we normally see. And these are just things that, this is on my iPad I carry around, and I'm up in a Black Hawk helicopter looking at this, and I can click on those maps and see crest. That's the power of what you're able to do on this tool. We did something in Minnesota last year too. We passed universal free meals, breakfast and lunch. Never again are we going to give a kid a different colored lunch ticket to try and shame them. And we implemented this, and what we saw was what you would expect. Because the critics said, we already have this free program. Yeah, it's hell. You got to fill out all this paperwork. You have to do this. And then it separated in that lunchroom. But once we did it, we started gathering data about where was it at, what did we use. And then kids are able to eat. For example, Ely up in northwest Minnesota, they went from 217 students being able to eat there to 536, 147% increase. Oh, and guess what happened too? Truancy rates went down and achievement rates went up and behavioral issues went down. Funny how a kid has food in their stomach, it works. We need to talk like hell about the good work that we're doing in GIS. Look, we have a vision of what we want to see our world to be, and I believe you've got to have the visionaries. You've got to be, it has to be aspirational. But my wife often reminds me, you can't hope we stop global warming. You can't hope we bring equity into how we're doing power and economic justice and environmental justice. You have to have a plan. The tools for that plan are GIS, the tools set in front of us, how we can transfer a vision of a fairer society into one that actually has results. You can start to make true differences, true ways to unite our world, true ability to be able to bring things together. Thank you.